This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so in the last class we have seen about how to create a folder in the file system class, how to create a folder, how to copy the files from one folder to another folder, how to delete the files from a folder, and how to delete the folder itself, and how to copy a single file, okay, into a folder, and how to copy the same extension files, like how to copy only Excel files, okay, from one folder to another folder, or only text files, okay, from one folder to another folder. Okay, suppose if you have multiple extensions, like in a folder I have Excel file, XML file, text file is there. Okay, just take a minute. So if you have multiple files in a folder, how to copy the only Excel files? Okay, suppose in a folder if you have XML file, okay, text file, Excel file, how to copy only the text files, like that we have shown at the last class. Now let us say I want to copy multiple extension files, not only text files. I want to copy, okay, text files as well as XML files. So in this folder, let us go for in the F drive. So let us say images. Let me go for images. So in this, we have an images folder is there. Let me go for it. Yeah, so in this folder, in this file, in this folder we have multiple extensions. Okay, okay, so we have JPG files, we have Excel file, we have text file, no? Now I want to copy only the XML files as well as text files. I want to copy only the XML files as well as the text files. Okay, I want to copy only the XML files and the text files, multiple extension files. Then how we can do that? Okay, so now let us see how we can do that. So when you want to copy a single extension file, how we have done? We have taken a for each loop container, and inside the for each loop container we have specified the folder path. So inside the collection you can see we have specified the enumerator as file enumerator, and we have specified the folder path, and we have specified what type of extension you want to retrieve. Okay, this is a single extension files. Now if I want to copy the multiple extension files, okay, then how we can do that is, so let me take one more time the for each loop container. Okay, so let me take one more time. So in this for each loop container, go to the collection. So since we are dealing with the files and folders, okay, so let us say the enumerator type is file enumerator only, and let us specify the folder path from which folder you want to copy the files. So my files are present in the F drive images folder, no? So let us locate your folder. So under this PC, okay, we have F drive. Under this F drive we have images folder. This folder data I want to copy. Okay, now you want to copy the XML file as well as text file, no? So star dot. Okay, star dot. You want to copy XML files, comma, text files, no? Star dot txt. Okay, if you specify like this, it won't work. It won't work. Okay, so let us try this. Okay, so I want to copy the, let us try in this format. I want to copy the XML files and text files. Then I have given like this star.xml, comma star.txt. Now let us take the file path. What this container will do? It will connect to this folder. It will take this XML file and it will take one by one file and put the path. Put the file path. File path is nothing but where it is located. Okay, so it will go to that folder. Let me go to that folder. So it will go to that folder, okay. F drive images. What is the file path means? Where from where it has to copy this file. Now you are want to copy the XML file, no? So it will go to this file path means nothing but so from which path it has to copy. Okay. So in this folder, okay, images folder, the file name is patch.sapna.xml. No? So that is the file path. Okay. So if you go to this, if you go to the properties of this file, so which will have the fully qualified path. Okay, now you can see under the security. So we have this, this is called file path. Okay, from where you want to copy. Okay, so the container will capture this file path, okay, in a variable. So inside this, we will store that file path. So let us say I can reuse that file path variable. Okay. Or if you want to go for a new file path, you can go and create a new variable. So let us say v underscore full path of the file. Okay, I'm declaring one more variable. Okay, and it is of string data type, yes. So now you can see variable underscore full file path. So whatever is the path name here, it is showing, no? So this path name, this name will be stored in this variable and it will repeat the same for one by one file. Okay, that is what the container will do. So it will connect to this folder. It will get this type of extension files one by one and that it will capture, it will copy that file path in this variable. Okay, and after copying the file path, so now let us take the copy single file operation and put it here. Okay, now let us take a copy of this. Okay, and paste it here. Okay, so now inside this copy single file. Okay, now is your source path is coming. So first of all, we will select the copy file operation here. So we will select the copy file operation here. And is your source path is coming in a variable? Yes, my source path is coming in a variable. So let me make it as true. Now, in which variable your source path is coming? Under the v underscore full file path. No, let us go. So from this variable, okay, my source path is coming in this variable. Okay, now where you want to copy? So destination, this we already know. So we want to copy to the folder which is present in the desktop. No, let us see whether that is still there or not. So you can see SSISRB is still there. Okay, now let me delete all these files. Okay, now my folder is empty here. Okay, so I have a folder in the destination desktop. Okay. I want to copy that files into the destination. If the file is already existing, do you want to overwrite? Yes, I want to overwrite. Okay, now let us say copy multiple extension files. Multiple extension files. Okay, that's it. Now let us see whether now this is, we have declared a variable and we have not specified any default value. Let me declare it. Okay, so this also we have already seen it. Okay, so why it is that error is coming is v full file path is used as a source or destination and is empty, you know, so that's why I have given some default value for this variable. Okay, now let us go on double click and click on okay. Now it is gone. Now let us see whether, as we suggested, whether it will copy XML and as well as text out. So now you can go and see. So now we can see that it is showing it as success, but let us see whether the destination has the destination, whether the required files are there or not. So you can see the folder is empty, means it has not copied anything. Okay, it has not copied anything here. Okay, okay, now so even though it is success, it has not copied anything here. Okay, so why it is not copied is, okay, it is just treating this as, okay, it is just treating this as a single extension. Now you can see it is going and checking in that file, in that folder, it is going and checking whether is there any file present with this extension like .xml, .txt. So whatever you give in after the first dot, no, it will treat this as this entire thing as a extension. So it is going and checking there is no file with extension .xml, .txt, star.txt. So that's why it is not able to copy anything. It will treat whatever the thing after the first dot, whatever it is available, it will treat entire thing as a single extension. Okay, then how we can copy multiple extension files is, then first of all, okay, get all the files. So star dot star means it will copy all the extension files. First of all, get all the extensions. Okay, and each and every file path will be placed in this variable. Okay, now after that, what we can do is, okay, let me use the script task here. Let me use the script task. Okay, so now inside the script task, what we will do, we will just display the value. No, so let me just display the value. So read only variables. So which variable data I want to read? I want to read v full path. Okay, now let me use the script task to display the value present in that variable. So this is one of the interview question. Okay, so they will ask you that how we can copy a single extension files, and they can ask you that how we can copy a multiple extensions. not only XML, how you can copy text to files also. Okay. So it will open our C sharp window. Let us see. Let me. So I think that is not opening now. Yeah, finally it is opening. Let us see. So how we can display the variable. So inside this Visual Studio, so after clicking on this, so after clicking on this edit script, so it has opened the Visual Studio window where we can write our C sharp.NET language, you know. So how we can display the variable data, we can just use message box, okay, dot show, okay. So dts dot variables, okay, variable name. So either you can give the variable name so either you can give the variable name like this. This is the variable name, so it will go and display the variable name here, okay, dot value dot toast. Okay, which will go and display the variable name like this. Okay, save it. Okay, and build it. So this is how we can display the variable name. Now, either you can give the variable name or you can give the variable index position also. So either you can give variables of 0, since only one variable is there, you can give it as index position as 0. Okay, both are same. Now this script task will display the list of files present in that file path. Okay, now after this, okay, go to the script task. Okay, after this we are going to the copy file option. Now in this arrow, okay, now in this arrow, okay, when you double click on this arrow, so here you can see that we can write a, not only constraint, we can write a expression also here. Okay, so you can select this expression and the constraint, and you can write filter out the file names here, filter out the file names here. Okay, so your file name is coming in this variable now. So v underscore full path, your file name, file path is coming in this variable now. So how the your file path is looking like, so it will have the folder name. So if you go to this, so how the file path will be looking like, so it will have the drive name, folder name, okay, it will have the drive name, folder name, and the file name dot xml. Means if it is xml file, it will have the last three letters as, or last four letters as XML, no? So that is what I will write it here. So I will go to this, and here I can say you want to copy only the XML and text files, no? Then I will get in this variable, okay, you are getting the file path, no? So if the last three characters, let us say write of comma 3, write comma 3 will give me the last three characters, no? So if it is equal to XML, if it is equal to XML, I will write a condition like if it is equal to XML or. So how we can write the or operator? So you can write the or operator like this, two vertical bars. Okay, so this is how we can write a or operator in the SSIS. We can go on cross check. We have the operators list here. So you can see or operator can be write like this. It includes or, like, it's a logical or, that is two vertical bars. Okay, that's what I'm specifying. Or if you are lost three letters of the file path, okay, is equal to text files. So what is the extension for text file? It is txt, you know, that's it. Okay, so in the file path, if the last three letters is XML or last three letters is equal to text, okay, then only go to the next task. We are here, we are putting a filter here, we are writing a where class here. Okay, if your file path name contains last three letters as XML or text, then only send that to the next window, to the next copy file option, copy file task. Okay, and we know that SSIS is case sensitive, no? So if it has dot capital XML, then it will treat it as different file. So since SSIS is a case sensitive, what I will do is I will convert the file path to lower case first. Lower of this last three characters is equal to XML or lower case of, okay, last three letters of the file path is equal to small txt. Here also small XML, small txt. That's it. Okay, now you can go and see. So from the container, we are passing all the files star dot star. So if it is JPG, if it is XLS, okay, if it is XML or if it is text, we are taking all the files, okay, all the file path, and we are putting into this variable. And first of all, what we are checking is, hey, if for the file path, okay, if the file path last three characters is XML or text, then only allow that to the next level. Okay, that's it. Now you can go and see. If I execute this container, so now you can see, first of all, the script as is displaying the value present in that variable, no? So it is saying that from this file, what is the first file name? So the first file name is 4.jpg, no? So now that particular first file name has come into this pipeline. Now you can see the script as is displaying the full path. Now is this extension is XML or TXT? No. Now you can see, is that file name went to the next level? No. Okay, it has not gone to the next level. Now you can see JPG also won't go. Okay, JPG also won't go. Now you can see XLS, this is also not allowed. Now you can see now the text file is coming. Now let us see whether it will go to the next level or not. Now you can see it has, now you can see there is a tick mark here. Means it has copied the text file. Now you can go and check in your desktop. Okay, let us go and open this. Is it already open? So now you can see SSIS ABI folder. Okay, SSIS ABI folder. Okay, only the one text file is present. So it has not allowed the JPG or Excel files to copy. Okay, only it will allow. Okay, it will allow only the Excel file. Now it won't allow. Now XML file it will allow. XML file it will allow. Text file it will allow. Text file it will allow. Now you can go and see. It might have copied only the XML files and the text files. Okay. So this is how we can copy the multiple XML, multiple files, extension files. Okay. So this is very, very important interview question. Okay. Everyone can tell how we can copy all the files or how we can copy a single extension files. But okay, if you want to copy multiple extension files, how we can do that? Okay. So now, one more observation is, now let us see, if after using the script task, okay, I am in this connector, I am putting a filter, okay, and what is the drawback of script task is, if you are using script task to display the label, okay, so somebody is there, should be there to click on it. If you click on okay, then only it will continue. Now let me show that also. So if I use the script task, now what is the problem is I can use the script task in the up to the testing stage, but I cannot use script task, okay, script task for display purpose in the production. Why? Because okay, now you can see it won't continue unless I click on the okay. So using script task, I am displaying this label. Okay, that is okay. And after script task only I have written some condition here, but if I in the production, who will be there to click on this okay button? If I click on okay, then only it will continue. Okay, unless I don't click on okay, it won't continue with the next level, next file extend, next file. Okay, so now you can see we have to manually click on okay button, then only it will go on continue with the execution. But in the testing, in the test phase or in the development stage, okay, somebody will click on okay. But in the production, who will be there to click on okay? No one will be there, no? So I can use the script as for display purpose at the up to the staging level only. But when I am deploying this solution to the production, I have to remove this script task. So when I am deploying to the production, I have to compulsory remove that. Now how can I apply filter? Why? Because in the connector itself we have applied the filter. Only in the connector we have applied the filter. Now we have removed that connector, we have removed the script as, then how can I apply the filtering now? Then how we can apply is, you can make any, you can take any one of them and you can make that as a dummy task. Now you can see I have taken one data flow task, but I don't do anything inside it. So I just use it, but I don't do anything here. Okay, I just need this arrow. No, I will connect this arrow here, and in this arrow I can write a, in this arrow I can write a expression here. Okay, I'm just copying that. Okay, now we can see instead of script task, we can use any other task, and just for dummy, I can just make it as a dummy task. You don't use anything, you don't do anything in that task. That like that also you can use. Now we can go and see. Let me show you one more time. Let me remove all the files. Okay. WBB go all the files. Now we can go and see. So instead of script task, you can use, you can drag and drop any other task and just make it as a dummy task. So now we can see we are able to copy here. Okay. Okay, we are able to copy the required extension files. Okay. Understood? Okay, any other doubts? Okay, so this is how we can copy the, this is how we can use the file system task, okay, in so many varieties. Okay. So this is about the execute SQL task and this is about the file system task. Okay, now let me cover, since we have some time now, let me cover some another task, that is bulk insert task also. Okay. So let me go for bulk insert task. So maximum in this week, okay, we will try to finish off this SSIS. Okay, so let me go for this bulk insert task. Okay, so what is this bulk insert task window? So what is this bulk insert task will do is, okay, if you want to copy the files, okay, if you want to copy the any text file data into the SQL Server table, okay, using this task, we can bulkly load the data from a text file into the SQL table. Let us show you that. So you can see, go to the connection. So here you can see we have source as well as destination also is there. Okay, so usually how we can copy the file, how you can copy the text file data into the SQL Server. So one option is you can go to this. One option is you can go to the data flow task. If you want to copy the text file data into the SQL Server, you can go to the data flow task, and inside the data flow task, we can select the source type as flat file source, okay, and locate a connection. So we can create a connection to that flat file source, either CSV or TXT files. So now let us say some bulk load connection. Okay, now let us browse for the file. So here you can go and see under the desktop. So do we have any bulk load file or anything? So let me show some text file. Bulk load or something like that. So any text file we can take, but let me show some bulk data. We have some sample history. So there is some huge data. So you can see we have so much data is there, okay, present in the table. Okay, we have so much data present in the table. Suppose if you want to copy some more times, okay, you can copy that, no problem. So some huge data is there. Okay, let me copy one more time. So there is some huge data is there. Okay, in this file. Now EMP bulk test. So if you want to copy through normal flow, that is taking a data flow task, okay, going inside this flat file source, and you want to bring a connection, you need to create a connection to the text file. So you can go and do like this. No, so let us say bulk data. Okay, load, go for browse. So under the desktop we have one folder called batch source files. Under this we have one text file called emp bulk text is there. Do you want to preview the data? Yes, I want to preview the data. So there are some huge data is there. So usually we will go do like this. Okay, now we'll get the flat file source and go to the destination. Okay, let us say go to the OLEDB destination and can create a, so let us say DB Abhishek, if you want to go and create a new table. Okay, so let us say table underscore bulk load bulk EMP employee load. Okay, so we'll go and create a table like this now. So usually we'll go and create a table like this. Okay, so go to the mappings. So usually we will take the flat file and do this. Okay, instead of these two steps, okay, instead of doing these two steps, what we can do is, now let me disable this. Okay, instead of these two steps, okay, we can handle it in a single step by using this bulk insert task. So now you can go and see that inside the bulk insert task, go to the connection. So here we can specify the source connection file. Now let us see bulk data load. Since we have already created the connection, no, I can just reuse it. Okay, so or you can need to map it. Okay, or since the connection is already there, I'm just reusing it. Now where is your, in which server you want to load? I want to load in the DB Abhishek. Into which table? So let us say whether that table is created or not. So it is not at there. Yeah, you can see the table is already there. Let us select this table underscore bulk underscore EMP load. Okay, so we are doing the two steps inside a single task. That's it. Okay, so now it will go and bulk data load, and it will go and load this data. Okay, so this is the source and this is where you want to copy, this is the destination. But here we have to specify how the column values and how the row values are separated in that file. So in this text file, okay, in this text file, how the rows and columns are separated. So column values are separated by comma, single line. Okay, single, each column value is separated by a comma. And how the rows are separated? By the new line character. No, so the rows are separated by new lines, column values are separated by comma, so we have to specify them. So here the column values are separated by comma, and the row values are separated by new line characters. That is nothing but CRLF means that is called new line character. That's it. So now we can go and see. So let us go to the Abhishek and let us see whether that table is created or not. Now let us see whether the table is it seems the table is existed. Now you can see the table is existed. Okay, now let us go and execute this. So we have specified the from where we need to copy and how the rows and columns are separated in that text file and where you want to copy the final destination. That's it. Okay, so now this also will do the same thing. It will get the data from the text file and load it into the SQL table, destination SQL table. But let us see whether it will execute successfully or not. So now we can see it has executed successfully. Now we can go and say, let me execute this. So now we can see that, so it has loaded the data. But the column names, you can see the column names are coming as a first row data. So why? Because here in this text file, if you go and see that inside the text file, so the first record is the column names. Okay, so that's why it is also stored the column names here in the first row. It has stored the column names, but you don't want to store the column names again. Why? Because the table, in the table already you have the column names, but this first row is storing the column names as one of the row data. I want to remove this first row. I don't want to copy the data from the first row. I want to copy the data from the second row. Then how we can do that? Now let us delete the data one more time. Delete from table underscore bulk underscore EMP underscore load. Okay, now there is no data. Okay, only table schema is present. There is no data. Column names are already present. Okay, I want to start copy the data from the second row. I want to copy the data from the second row. Okay, then how we can specify inside the bulk insert task, how we can specify? So how we can specify it is, let us see. So inside the bulk insert task, we have some option called, so we have some options called, do you want to copy the data from the first row? No, I don't want to copy the data from the first row. First row, start the copying the data from the second row. Okay, so we can specify here. So we can specify the first row and the last row. Suppose if you want to copy only the 100 records, you can go and specify last row as 100. Okay, this option also is there. Okay, now you can see it will copy the data from the second row and it will end up to the 100 rows only. Now let us go and execute.
So now
that was executed successfully. Now let us go and see. So either you can copy the entire data. Now you can see, is the first column is coming, first row is coming? No, it is started copying the data from the second row. And how many rows are there? You can go and see from the second row to the 99th row. Okay, up to the 100th row it has copied. Okay, you can set the number of records you want to copy. Okay, or do you want to process in the batch? Okay, that also you can specify. Okay, batch size. Okay, if you are copying 500 records for each batch, how many records you want to take? Okay, so if you specify as 5, it will take, it will divide the data into 5 batches and it will execute fastly. Okay, so code page, let it be raw. Okay, data file type, then let it be character only. And we have another option called check constraints. Constraint means if any foreign key or identity seed value or primary key constraint. So primary key constraint, it won't allow duplicates. So if you want to follow the same, then you can go and click on check constraints. So do you want to keep the null values? Okay, or enable identity insert. Say on the table, there is extra column which has identity seed. Do you want to enable that? Yes. Do you want to lock the table when you are loading the data? Yes, you can lock the table. Do you want to fire the triggers if the table has any triggers written on the table? If there are any triggers are present, do you want to fire them? Yes, you can go and fire it. Like this. So this is about the bulk insert task. Okay, so in tomorrow class we will go for next big one, that is XML task. So we have the next big one is XML task. Okay, so remaining are all very very simple. Okay, so we have only bigger ones are data flow task, execute SQL task, file system task and XML task. Remaining are simple only. Okay. Can I stop now? Yeah. Thank you guys.